Bellator 255 premiered on Showtime from the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut. And we started the night with a flyweight matchup between Alejandra Lara and the undefeated Kana Watanabe.
Gotta love the energy that Alejandra Lara brings in the fight. She's happy to be there. Kana Watanabe getting lit up at the beginning, that leg kick and then those shots. Lara breaks away, comes back with, again, aggressive stand-up. But look at that outside reap of the leg to put her on her back. It was the judo of Kana Watanabe that eventually started to just take its toll on Alejandra Lara. She tried to get space. She landed beautiful elbows across both sides of Watanabe's face, but it still wasn't enough. And the judo came back, takes the legs out, gets into positions, takes the back, lots of ground and pound. It was just too strong in the end with her heavy hips and ground effects. She made Lara work. Lara tried to get up, unable to. Kana Watanabe takes the unanimous decision victory that she well deserved.
Next in the cage were the lightweights, the much-anticipated Bellator MMA debut of the undefeated Usman Nurmagomedov against the double-tough Mike Hamill.
Boy, gritty and tough, you are so right, Moro. Mike Hamill just kept coming forward, but it was Usman Nurmagomedov that just put on a display of striking that was just something special. He was up, down, body, head, legs. Look at that kick to the body. He just systematically broke Mike Hamill down and got his first Bellator win in his Bellator debut.
Following that, the heavyweights ran it back as Tyrell Fortune and Jack May settled their scores.
Well, this was a repeat of a fight that ended in no contest due to a foul, and these guys do not like each other, and it was the wrestling of Tyrell Fortune. Jack May could not stop that takedown, could not get position, and just started accepting a lot of damage to the point that Dan Mergulata looked and said, you gotta do something. He didn't see anything. And a stop to that fight, a beautiful TKO victory for Tyrell Fortune. Now with his 10th Bellator win.
In the co-feature attraction in the welterweight division, former title challenger Naaman Gracie took on Jason Jackson.
Man, we were all expecting this to be a great fight, but it really turned into a weird fight. Here's the weird part right here. Watch Jason Jackson's face. He rubs his eye into the cage, and he damages his eye, kind of stops fighting there. And Naaman Gracie kind of stops a little bit, but he comes up, takes his back, and ends in a position where he's on his back, but Jason Jackson fights his way through it. And with that, Naaman Gracie goes back to getting on his back. Jason Jackson again fights his way through it. All of the takedowns, all of the submission attempts, none of them work. Jason Jackson reversing that takedown, getting top position. He did just enough in the judge's eye to land enough strikes. They give him a split decision victory.
And in the main event, with both the featherweight belt and a trip to the Grand Prix final on the line, it was Patricio Pitbull versus Emmanuel Sanchez, part deux.
Part done. We expected a little bit of a different fight than the first time, and it was. But it was Pitbull doing what he does now, taking the center of the cage and waiting for those powerful counters. He lands that beautiful left hand and then gets that guillotine in place. And once he jumps, you know that it's tight. And he puts him to sleep with a guillotine hold. Pitbull takes the featherweight Grand Prix, second spot in the finals, keeps his championship, and now faces AJ McKee in the finals.
Patricio Pitbull will face the unbeaten AJ McKee. McKee, 17-0, the number one ranked featherweight in Bellator. He'll meet the champ in the final with a $1 million bonus check also up for grabs. For the latest Bellator news and information, go to Bellator.com.
The toughest division in MMA goes to battle in the best tournament yet. S2 Division champ, Ryan Darth Vader.
Oh, look at what Vader can do.
Clashes with Counter-Strike artist, Lyoto Machida.
A knee strike by Machida.
That perfect storm is coming for the Grand Prix.
Who will reign on the road to gold? The Bellator MMA Light Heavyweight World Grand Prix kicks off next Friday on Showtime.